Hey, Shalom, Shalom, when it's all souls, but giving no praise to Yahweh, Hashem, Yahshua, Hashem, Rakak, Kudash, double honors, the apostles of James, and honors to you, brothers, doing the work in truth, while sincerity. This is a quick one on, basically just on the kingdom, right? And it's just a thing of, like, you know, mentioned it at the camp, something that was on my mind, before camp yesterday's. You know, you'll see certain people, they'll be doing certain things, going certain places, you know, quote unquote, enjoying life, right? As it's put in the world. And then, you know, you may get envious. You may be like, I want to do that, I want to do, but they have this world, and this world is wicked, right? In fact, let me get that. But they have this world, and this world is wicked. But we have, you know, we seek one to come. This is Hebrews 13:14. It says, for here we have no continuing city, but we seek one to come. Right? And why don't we have any continuing city here? It says Micah 2:10. Right? It says, arise ye and depart, for this is not your rest. Right? And it ain't our rest. But ultimately we're here, and we're suffering because we went off. Right, and this is our punishment, and you know, you can't be enjoying time, you know, in your punishment, right? You're being punished, you know, it's like getting beats, and then the beats are enjoyable, then that's no longer a punishment, right? For instance, you may have got to a point where your parents couldn't give you beats anymore, right? Because it didn't hurt or whatever, so your parents had to come up with new ways to chastise you. Why? Because it was no longer a punishment, right? This place is our punishment. So if we're all enjoying it, then, you know, then we ain't being punished, right? It says because it is polluted, and right, well, how's it polluted? Homosexuality, transgenderism, all manners of wickedness being pushed on people, and the thing is, people just run with it. They're like, cool, right? And then you say, oh, I ain't down with that. Oh, why? You know, people are trying to get on you, trying to push their wickedness on you. Right, it says it shall destroy you, and that's right, right? You know, because these people are trying to infect you with their philosophies, right? And you know, for instance, you might have a Jake, you know, he ain't down with homosexuality, but it gets beaten into him, right? And the next thing you know, he starts, you know, dabbling in that field of things, right? It says it shall destroy you, even with the sword destruction. Yeah, so for instance, using homosexuality as an example. Right, you know, what is the recompense for that? You read Leviticus 20:13. The recompense for that is your, you know, your blood shall be upon you, right? You know, i.e. you shall be put to death, right, according to the law. Well, obviously in this world, you know, that law isn't kept, it isn't executed, right? It's quite the contrary. You read Isaiah 29:16, right? It says, surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as the potter's clay, right? You know, and all of these laws, you know, have been turned upside down. This world has been turned upside down, right? To the point where the scriptures say homosexuality is, you know, regressive, right? Scriptures say it's an abomination, salakia, right? You know, scriptures say it's an abomination, and anyone who partakes shall be put to death. But this world celebrates it. Right, that's why we can't enjoy this world, right? For instance, you know, you might see some, you know, pictures of the Northern Lights, be like, yo man, I want to, you know, enjoy going there, whatever. Or you might see this, or might see that, I want to go and, you know, see that and enjoy it. But the truth is, you can't really enjoy it, because you'll be there, you'll see some homosexuals kissing under the Northern Lights, for instance, right? Or you'll go to, you know, I don't know, Amsterdam, see some, you know, transsexuals in the, because prostitution is legal over there, right? You might see them in a brothel somewhere, right? And that's why it says this place shall destroy, because you'll be out there trying to get some, you know, some pussy and that, and you damn near don't know what's what anymore, right? You go to Matthew 24:22, what does it say? Right, it says, and except those days should be shortened, they should no flesh be saved, but for the elect's sake those days shall be shortened. Right, so if the Lord doesn't come back, we're all fucked, right? Man is fucked. The animals are fucked. The planet's fucked. Why? Because you've got Esau on rulership, and that's ultimately why we can't enjoy anything on this side, because you've got Esau, the wicked, in rulership. Right, and his vibration is sent out throughout all the earth. Right? Now, you might go to a remote place somewhere, right? And then, you know, you're thinking, yeah, it's cool, whatever. Then you might see a turtle come up the beach, and he's got a fucking beer. You know, you get the six-pack of beer. You know, you might, and it has its spalma, that plastic. Right, its neck might be stuck in that, you know, one of those crates of, in that plastic wrap thing. Right, which is a real issue, right? So you might be hundreds, thousands of miles away from, you know, you're never thousands of miles away from an Edomite. We might be, you know, a long way away from an Edomite, right? And what do you call it? And then you're seeing the effects that he's having on the place, right? Or worse yet, you might be around the locals, and then they're all lamenting because they ain't no fish in the sea anymore. And why is that? Because Esau's killed it. So then here it is, you're all enjoying, you're trying to enjoy yourself, but then you're always reminded of this man's effect on the planet, right? This man's effect on the world, on life itself, right? This is Matthew, you know, I'm just going to get, you know, scriptures, you know, on the topic. Right, it says Matthew 19:27 says, then answered Peter and said unto him, right, unto Yahweh Shai, behold, we are forsaken all and follow thee. What shall we have therefore? And Yahweh Shai said unto them, verily I say unto you, that ye which have followed me in the regeneration, when the Son of Man shall sit in the throne of his glory, ye also shall sit upon 12 thrones, judging the 12 tribes of Israel. Right, and everyone that hath forsaken houses, or brethren, or sisters, or father, or mother, or wife, or children, or lands, for my name's sake, shall receive an hundredfold, and shall inherit everlasting life. Right. So, you know, in the kingdom, you know, on this side, right, you know, one thing that, you know, men enjoy, for instance, is, you know, their children, their wife, right, you know, that family guy life. Right. That's one of the things of enjoyment on this side. But in truth, on this side, we can't really enjoy those things. Right, let me get this real quick. Right, this is 1 Corinthians 7. It's 1 Corinthians 7 and 29. It says, but this I say, brethren, the time is short. It remaineth that both they that have wives be as though they have none. Right? So more time you won't be able to, that scripture is pretty plain on that one, right? It's, they that have wives be as though they had none, right? So she ain't gonna be priority, period, right? This truth comes first, right? Which, you know, is already, you know, women are jealous, that's already a problem, right? And what do you call it? Let me find this here. I mean, it's in here somewhere. The 1 Corinthians 7 chapter says, you know, if you have a woman, you shall have trouble in the flesh, right? So those are the things that we won't be able to enjoy on this side. And plus, anyway, you haven't got a woman. Esau's her man, right? And proof of that is, tell her not to wear trousers. You know, tell her to, you know, have her head wrapped, right? You know, tell her, tell her to treat you like how the women of old treat their men, right? You know, tell her you're getting another woman, right? She's going to have a problem with all of that. Why? Because she's Esau's woman, right? You just get to loan it for the time being, right? Up until the point, you know, she's saved with you, right? She's Esau's woman because this is Esau's world. It's Esau's realm and she's been infected by him, right? That's why we got to be brainwashed, right, through these scriptures, right? Our minds cleansed from the wickedness of this world, right? You know, inward man renewed day by day, as the scripture hath said, right? It says Psalm 16 and 11, it says, thou wilt show me the path of life, in thy presence is fullness of joy, at thy right hand there are pleasures forevermore, right? So there are pleasures evermore that the, you know, that the Lord hath prepared, right? So it should say, no eye hath seen, right? Or ear heard. In fact, let me find that, right? This is Isaiah 64:4. It says, "For since the beginning of the world, men have not heard nor perceived by their ear, neither hath the eye seen, O power, beside thee, what he hath prepared for him that waiteth for him." Right, so no one seen or heard what it is that the Lord has prepared, but we know it's good. Right, that much we know. Right, and like I said, on this side, there are things that you may want to do, you know, but, you know, now may not be the time to do those things, right? Now may not be the time. And it's just a thing of patience, waiting until, you know, the Lord, gives us these things. Because ultimately it's the Most High that gives us anything anyway, right? The Lord knows what it is that you want before you've even asked for it. Right, it says Isaiah 60:22, it says, "A little one shall become a thousand, and a small one a strong nation. I, the Lord, will hasten it in his time." Right, and this whole chapter is the kingdom, about how, you know, the goodies can, how these heathens are gonna bring, you know, their goodies to us, right? And right now, man, hey, money is always an issue for Jake right now. Right, but in the kingdom it won't be. Right, money is just going to be this thing that just exists, like in the time of King Solomon. Right, it says, silver was as for stones. Right, it says, John 14:2 says, "In my Father's house are many mansions." That's talking about all of these different planets. Right, the Lord is preparing for us. Right, for instance, I was saying, you may want to go holiday to this place, that place, might want to go see. Well, now ain't the time to be in that holiday spirit, right? You know, you might want to go to this place, that place, and then, you know, see, oh yeah, man, I want to see this, you know, see this, whatever, what have you. But in truth, right, you know, in the kingdom, we going be visiting different planets, man, which is what this is going into. Right, it says, "If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you." Right, so that's being prepped for us, man. Right, and then, you know, the Spirit had to worry about this. It's kind of touched on different aspects of the kingdom, the women, right? You know, enjoyment of, you know, the different deity things, you know, of this planet that the Lord has created, right? And then then you have, you know, it's touched into, you know, family, children, right? And this one is touching into women, right? And this is even before the kingdom, right? It says Isaiah 4, right? It says, "And in that day, seven women shall take hold of one man, saying, we will eat our own bread and wear our own apparel. Only let us be called by thy name to take away our reproach," right? So in that day, seven women, right, a complete amount of women, right, shall take hold of one man. So women ain't going to be an issue. And in that day, women are really going to be a liability, which is why it says what it says. We will eat our own bread, right, and wear our own apparel, right? Basically saying, look, man, we won't be a burden to you, right, with, in terms of resources, but let us just be under your protection. That's a man of the Lord, right? So even before the kingdom, women are not going to be an issue. So imagine in the kingdom, right, you know, we're going to have loads of children, right? And for you to have loads of children, it means you're going to have loads of women, right? And that just goes by default, right? But yeah, it looks like all I had, right? You said, you know, this ain't our world, but we have the kingdom, right? And we can have all the enjoyment we want, all the fun, all the things we missed out on this side because we had to do this work. We have to, stay loyal to the Lord, right? All those things we're going to have in righteousness in the kingdom, right? all those places we wanted to see, we're going to be able to see in righteousness in the kingdom, and not have Esau, the so-called white man, get in the way of that, right? So, Lord's will, that was edifying. Till the next time, Shalom.